Then he called me a butterknife, because a real man would be represented by more barbarous instruments, such as steel steak knives or hammers or Black and Decker power drills and so on. Butterknife. Butterknife. Furthermore, I knew this to be referring specifically to a butterknife that I carved myself in the real world in that year in Finland that I told you about. I was at a farmhouse on a lake, a small outpost of a building, with a typical hot stone sauna several meters from a clean, blue, crystalline lake. I was there for about a week or so, and in my time, at some stage, I forget exactly why, save for the fact that it was something of a tradition, and nearly every Scandinavian household had a handmade butterknife in its kitchen drawer. I thought it a rather quaint and lovely tradition, and as you can imagine, I had more than enough time on my hands. So I found a sufficient piece of wood to suit the occasion, and with the aid of a traditional metal knife, took some time to whittle it down into shape, smooth its edges and so on, and craft what, to this day, I still deem to be an excellent butterknife that has stayed with me since. It is mostly used to spread butter, but it should come as no surprise that it can also be used, and has been used, for spreading other condiments such as cashew cream, jams, and so on. But in this context, it was meant as an insult. And in the dream, his words did manage to pierce my facade and cause me some embarrassment. This, of course, gave me quite a chuckle when I awoke, as calling someone a butterknife is no insult at all.